This one's us. I know he loves me. I know he cares. Whenever I call, he always is right there. In times of trouble, he is my help. Yeah, I know no fear. I know he'll be right there. Hey, he really does what he says he will do. My God really moves. Oh, yeah. Why would I doubt when he always comes through? My God really moves. Oh. I know he loves me. I know he cares.
I know he cares.
Whenever
I come, he always is my help.
When I'm in trouble,
when I'm in trouble,
he is my help.
He is my help. Cause I know no fear. I know he's
come on.
My help.
He said, yeah. Come on, listen. No matter, you're always on time. You can't do no wrong. Oh, never. Come on. You leave the 99, always for the one.
Oh, never.
You're the God who does good.
Always on time.
Baba, baba, leave
the 99.
Come on,
forever.
Yeah.
Well, leave the 99, go get me, come get me. Leave the 99 and come get me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Prayer Life Ministry International prophetic Bible study on tonight. God is a great God. He is amazing. He is mighty. Right now, if you haven't already begun to share, glory to God, begin to share this. This is an opportunity for you. Welcome, replay viewers. God bless you in the name of Jesus as well. Hallelujah. If you know somebody who really needs the teaching of truth, by through the way, the truth, and the life, then tell them to come on over here to Prayer Life Ministries International prophetic Bible study. To God be the glory. I am so excited. I am Dr. Prophetess Hope Hall, and I'm excited what God is doing in this season. He's really pushing me as well. And so the push has been interesting. It's great. And it is, it can be tiresome, but in a good way. You know, it's not a way of complaining, because when you first give your life to Christ, it's so beautiful. It's amazing. We thank God for you. But I also know that there is also something on the other side of the door. And the something on the other side of the door is the work and the enemy. And so he's been sent to destroy everything you were feeling on that beautiful moment. He gonna let you have your moment. Cause that's, you know, he's like, they knew. So they knew something's gonna let them feel their moment for it. Cry it out, snot it out, have a great time for about a month. And here he comes and he's gonna pound on you. And then the question is, why didn't anybody ever tell me that this was going to happen? And you know what? And that is the problem with our people today. They don't tell people. When they invite people to come in, they don't come and stay with them. They don't share a meal with them, so to speak, with the word of the Lord. They just say, welcome, we welcome you in. You want to join our services? Okay, we welcome you in. And then that's it. You don't hear nothing else. And so I'm here to encourage all of you that even though you are taking the next step in Christ, or your first step in Christ, or you have backslidden, because we've all fallen short of the glory of God, and you need to take your next step in Christ, and you may be a little bit fearful because it felt so uncomfortable in the first place, or you find yourself in the middle of this war that seemed like it's hard. Remember the scriptures. There's two the Lord want me to remind you of, and then we're going to move on into the worship. And the number one scripture, when you're in that war, when they're coming for you and it's hard for you to think and it feels like it's difficult to get back to God, remember that the scripture says there is nothing too hard for my God. Now, y'all catch that? There's nothing too hard for God. Yeah, so that means that, okay, it's going to be hard for me. But if it's nothing too hard for God and you're still having a problem, you have placed your warfare in the wrong hands. You have placed your warfare in the hands of somebody else and allowing them to destroy who you know God is. Or you place your warfare in your own hands. So now your flesh has access to your soul, and it causes you to be really even in worse shape and not even near God anymore. Because now you're following the warfare. Now, the second scripture is, right, though the weapon may form, it will not prosper. And everything that comes up against you shall be condemned. That means God has made a promise to you. He's letting you know that you're going to go through some stuff. Warfare going to come for you in the name of Jesus. It's not going to feel good. And some of it going to feel like you're lost. You're like you're in the wilderness by yourself. And what did that song say? Leave the 99. He coming for you. But if you have no sights on him and you want to, hey, you want to do the warfare yourself, God said, I'm just going to stand here and wait on you. Since you don't need me, since you know there's nothing too hard for me and I'm a God of possibilities and limitlessness, and I'm the God that cancels all the weapons that are formed, though it may form, it won't prosper. Ooh. Well, that means that if I'm still fighting like this and I keep saying, oh, I can't do it. It's too much. It's too overwhelming. Well, yeah, it's overwhelming because you're taking it on yourself. It's going to be overwhelming. So why not in the middle of it, instead of talking about the situation, why not give God glory for the other side of through? Come on. I know that spoke to somebody right there. Give God glory for the other side of through. I am on this side of the storm, but I thank God he got a greater thing waiting on me. There's a reason why I'm going through this. Look, let me check me first and let me check myself in a worship space. Come on, glory to God. So we are worshiping God today. Glory to God. And I'm thinking about that war my husband, Apostle Dr. Howell, he played this song and now it's just like it goes perfectly. Cause I said, God, I need a song. So y'all come with me on this song when you're going through things. And I think of this song I don't know. Let me go ahead. So come on, y'all, let's, wherever you are, replay viewers, wherever you are, YouTubers, wherever you are, come on, give God glory right now. Right now is the time. When you're going through the warfare, it's the time. Hey, look, check this out. If y'all want to go back to another Bible study, when I gave you my testimony, because the warfare was great, but I gave him glory. I laid the word of God on my chest, knowing, glory to God, that he is a God that can do all things. So come on, when we go to worship, come on. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. I know my volume is acting funny today. To God be the glory. Maybe I need to try to do it without the volume. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. So here we go. So let's just worship him, right? Let's just give him glory. Come on, y'all, right now, wherever you are, just Father, thank you. I want you to think about everything that you're going through right now. And I want you to think about everything somebody else across the land is going through that's worse off than you. I want you to think about that your house is not inhabited by water and mud. And somebody on the other side ain't got no place to live because their houses are under the water. I want you to think about somebody that's worse off than you. You're breathing right now, and there's somebody needing a tube to breathe for them. Oh, God. You want you to think about that your brain is operating while somebody is being told now that they cannot, we have to let them go because it's the machine that's working the mind. Oh, God. I want y'all to just right now just say thank you, Lord. Because sometimes what looks huge to us is tiny for somebody else. It's bad for some. And I know somebody said, well, hey, a pain is a pain. And you might go through the same thing and you got that pain. But let me tell you something. That's why God is God. You can say a pain is pain. You can say, oh, I feel worse than you because 5 people died on my side of the fence and only 3 died on yours. Pain is pain. I stole a piece of gum while you robbed the bank. Sin is sin. So come on, give God glory for where you are right now. Don't complain about it. Say thank you, Lord. And if you're going through a storm, I dare you right now. I double dog dare you to trust God in it. I double dog dare you to really open up your ears and listen. Because listen, if you are blocking your ears and I sound like blah, blah to you, when I know who God is in me, then your life is just going to be full of blah, blah. because you're not going to hear God. It's just going to be blah, blah. And you're going to hear the blah, blah. But yet you're going to still be going through your own, trying to navigate some things that you can't navigate. The only one God can navigate for you. Glory to God. When the saints go to worship, that's when the King of Kings will come in. When the saints go up in praise, that's when the Spirit shall inhabit this place. When the saints get on one accord and begin to bless the Lord, then the King who's strong and mighty, oh, the King who's mighty in battle, yeah, the King of glory shall come in. When the saints go to worship, that's when deliverance will take place. When the saints go up in praise, all of Satan's powers are erased. Every trap the enemy set can't work. That's when the King who's strong and mighty, oh, the King who's mighty in battle, yes, the King of glory shall come in. We welcome you in. We welcome you in. Thank you, Jesus. You're the King, and you're invited to come in to this sanctuary. Oh, God, this tabernacle. You're the King, and you're invited to come in. Oh, hallelujah. You're Alpha and Omega. You're the beginning and the end. Your glory will come in where you are welcome. You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. You are Alpha. Come on, y'all, worship him. And Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. One more time, you're Alpha. You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. We give you all glory. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. Come on, come on, come on. We give you all glory. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Salvation and glory, honor and power unto the Lord our God. For the Lord our God is almighty. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, he is wonderful. All praises be to the King of Kings and the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God glory wherever you are. Come on, let's give him glory wherever you are. Let's give him worship wherever you are. When the saints go to worship, he's Alpha and Omega. Hallelujah. He's the King of Kings. We thank you, Lord, tonight. So Father, I pray for the apostle, your sent one, God, as he begins to breathe out your word, God. It is not from his voice, but it's your voice. It's not from his belly, his fleshly belly, but it's your belly, God, that flows rivers of living water that'll fall fresh on us, Lord, that'll give us another sense of idea of who you are. And it doesn't go, God, in a Messiah, a Messiah. I pray, God, that as he begins to read this word, that it taps into your heart. It begins to change some things. It begins to give you a kingdom mindset in the name of Jesus, to know that you have already won the victory. Oh, hallelujah. So come on, saints, let's go to worship. Come on, when the king comes in. When he goes to worship, we welcome him in. So tonight we welcome you in, King. We welcome you in, Holy Spirit. We welcome you into their homes tonight. We welcome you into their homes this morning, in the evening, wherever they're watching from, God, whatever side of the land they're watching from, whatever time of the day, God, you are God all day long. Let them receive this word, God, and begin to shift their mindset into a 4D mindset, knowing that they already have the victory. God, God bless you. I love you, people of God, in the name of Jesus. Dr. Apostle, it's on you. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Father, I just ask, I want to continue this prayer that my lovely wife brought forth in her worship, Father. Father, I just thank you right now. Father, I thank you that when this word comes forth, that I decrease, that you increase in me, Father. That any word that comes forth, I'm speaking from the throne, Father, the kingdom of God, Father, that it first it checks me, it corrects me, Father, and it adjusts me, Father, before it adjusts anyone else that's in the room, Father, because I yield and I surrender myself unto you right now, Father, because I just want to say the words that you say, Father. I want to think the things that you think, Father. So I just ask to speak this word that you have given me with clarity, Father, with understanding, and with power of your Holy Spirit and your glory to touch each and every one of the sound of my voice and even the replay viewers. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Welcome, everyone. Let's get right into it. We last week we started talking about 2 Timothy, 2nd chapter, the 21st verse. I'm going to read that again. That's what we want to get to. So basically the Bible study tonight will be 2 Timothy, the 2nd chapter. We'll be starting at the 16th, 17th, and 18th. That's the part that we'll be dealing with tonight. And we might have to do a little recap on 14 and 15. But I want to do 21 again. Now, I'm not going to go in depth because I had to, another Bible study. I'm really going to dive into this, because when I was studying on today, this is what God highlighted to me. And I just want to bring this part before I even start. Okay. 2 Timothy, the 2nd chapter, the 21st verse from the New American Standard Bible reads this: "Therefore, if anyone cleanse himself from these things, he will be a vessel for honor, sanctified, useful to the master, prepared for every good work." We all want to be useful to the master. We all want to be useful to our Father, that if we call God, the God of the Most High, our Father, we want to be useful, right? But the key word in this is said prepared. What does prepared means? Prepared means to make ready. Another word, it means equipped, right? Just as you are making a dinner and you have to prep the food before you place it in the oven, you remember it takes heat to cook your meal, but when it's ready, you know that meal is going to be awesome. But let me take it a little deeper, right? Just imagine God is prepping you, preparing you, right? So what he's doing, he has you. You are the clay. He's the potter, right? So he said, "My daughter, my son, right here, I need to add," you know, because a lot of times when we were prepping, say we were prepping a turkey or something like that, we add spices, we add vegetables, celery, onions, and whatever. So, but let's look at us. When we're on the table, he's shaping and molding us. Then he said, "You know what? I need this woman of God. I need this man of God, this child. I need to add a little word of wisdom in there," right? So he add a little word of wisdom there because he's equipping you for your journey and your purpose, right? Some of us, he said, "Well, you know, this one, as they go forth, they're going to need a little additional faith. So I'm going to add a little faith in there. I'm going to make it, you know, stand out." Then he's going to say, "Oh, yeah, this one right here. This one right here, I might need to add a little prophecy in there, have so she can have a strong, or he have a strong discernment of spirits or a prophecy that he be able to prophesy what I'm giving him," right? So he's like, "Well, what about this one? You know what? I'm going to take this daughter and I'm going to add miracles to her. Because if I add miracles to her, because when she faced some things, she'll be able to hold on and grab on and use the miracle that she's been equipped with when she run into a situation, and a miracle will be performed because I trust her with the miracle," right? He said a gift of healing. He said, "Okay, I'm going to take this son and I'm going to put a little healing gift of heaven and healing in that son, because I know what the journey he's going to face. He's going to have to lay hands on somebody and they're going to have to be restored. They're going to have to be recovered." So this is one of the things you got to understand. So prepare was standing out to me. So he's preparing us for every good work. So what we have to do, allow him to prep us. You know, just like we take our meal, we prep our meal. We don't expect our meal to jump off the pan that we are prepping it in, or we're not inspecting the vegetables or the spices or the juices, the oil that we use to not go where it's supposed to go, right? So this is the same thing God want us to do with us. He wanted, as he prepare us, he expect when he is dropping these spiritual gifts within you, the word of wisdom, word of knowledge, he wants you to use it for the master, use it for his purpose when it's time. So we got to be, understand he is prepping us for every good work that we endure in our life. All right, let's continue on. All right. So 2 Timothy, the 2nd chapter, the 14th verse, it talks about remind them of things and solemnly, which means seriously or sincerely, charge them in the presence of God, not to wrangle about words. One of the things I wanted to recap on that is the charge. The charge to assign a responsibility, a duty, an obligation to someone or something, right? My sister, when she was sharing last week, she gave me a reminder of the charge that during the ordination service that was given to the leaders, because it was important for their journey. It was important for their purpose. So it is needed. You know, it's like we just got to understand when we're giving instructions, we got to make sure the Holy Spirit is the one that's instructing us to give these instructions. Sometimes we don't need to get to the point where we're talking out of turn, because that's the words that we are giving empty. You'll see in verse 16 about empty chatter is when we give fruitly words, because fruitless words, because we just want to say something. We only can say something if God is directing and leading and guiding us to say something. Sometimes we have to be quiet and be still in the situation that we're dealing with, because God has not given us anything to say. Let me keep moving, because I want to start get toward my point. And we got to understand, I love the Passion Translation of verse 14. It says to never be drawn into meaningless arguments. That's what is one of the issues that divides the kingdom. When we get into meaningless arguments, or we tear each other down with useless words that only harm others. Because when people witness, like for example, you've been on social media, you see where, like, prime example, one of the last debates was, besides women ministering, is this movie Deliverance. You know, some say you should watch it, some say you don't watch it. And it was a big battle about it. I mean, my thing is, it's to each his own. I prefer not to watch it, because I've seen it live when the deliverance have taken place. So I don't need to watch a movie to tell me how deliverance go, because I've seen it in real life. But it's your own purpose, your own plan, you know, and you got to be careful what you watch, even on TV, not just that movie. It's any movie that you're dealing with. If it got a lot of negative content in there, you shouldn't be watching it anyway, because the only thing you're doing is open up portals, you open up you giving yourself opportunity for negative stuff to come into your ear gates, your eye gates, and it becomes an issue. That's why people struggle with porn, because they watch it and then it comes to the eye gates and ear gates, and it causes other things to happen. That's why you got to be careful what you watch. Not just that movie Deliverance. It's all type of content that is on TV these days. Social media. You know, you can get caught watching social media and then it goes left. Sometimes you got to be able to be strong enough to pull out of that, because it could pull you with it, right? So let me continue on. Like, we went to verse 15. Be diligent to present yourself approved to God as a workman who does not need to be ashamed, accurately handling the word of truth. And I remember I mentioned that our Father don't accept everything we give to him, especially if we give it to him half-hearted, or we don't give it to him totally. You want me to give you an example? In Genesis, the example I gave last week, he didn't accept Cain's sacrifice. Remember Cain and Abel, the story in Genesis? He accepted Abel, but he didn't accept Cain. So you can't just give God anything. One of the other things we're going to talk about, when it's talking about be diligent, it means you got to be study. You got to be attentive. You got to be thorough. You got to be meticulous when you're studying, so you can make sure you can grab every revelation that God has for you. And your revelation will grow as the deeper deeper the relationship. Let me do it that way. The deeper your relationship we have with the Father, the more revelation your revelation in him will grow. you'll be able to see things in some, like prime example. I gave you an example, Psalms 23. Now you can read that just like it is right now, but the deeper you build a relationship with God, you're able to get more revelation because you are really diving in and you're really spending time with you, and he's whispering with that still voice talking to you about things in Psalms 23 that is based on your life or what you need to hear right now to give you direction. Like, because remember 119, Psalms 119, 105 said, his word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. That's what happened. That's what revelation is. When you grab a hold of revelation by reading the word, it's starting to light your path, give you direction, give you insight, give you divine strategies in your mind so you know what to do next. Right? Let's continue on because I want to get. And it continues to say about correctly analyzing and accurately dividing the word of truth. This is one of the things we got to understand. This is one of the things I told all the clients, well, the members last week, is you need to get a concordance or a Bible dictionary because you need to go deeper in your study like never before. You want to be able to interpret God's word correctly and make sure you're saying what the word, what the context really means, because we have to be careful because sometimes what I word means does not what means does not mean that's what it mean in the Greek. Prime example, when we talk about walk, right? I learned this through studying that walk. Well, we move from walk, but in the Greek, walk means your conduct, your behavior, how you act. So we have to be mindful of that. So let's go to right quick, briefly, because I want to get through this. Verse 16. This is where we will start off tonight. This is where we will start off tonight. But avoid worldly and empty chatter, for it will lead to further ungodliness, and their talk will spread like gangrene. I know a lot of the gangrene, I remember that, as a young person, how they used to talk about that. That disease is not a good disease. And then some of the medical people that is part of study tonight understand what gangrene means, right? And it said, among Hymenus and Philetus, men who have gone astray from the truth, saying that the resurrection has already taken place. And they are upset the faith of some. Let's go back to the beginning. Avoid all empty conversations. As representing the kingdom of God, we got to be careful of the conversations we're having. What empty chatter means, fruitless. So basically, the conversation you have is not producing nothing. It's not producing nothing of God. You know what he did with the fig tree that it wasn't bearing? He cast it down. He withered it. He put it, struck it down because it wasn't producing, right? So we got to understand what empty chatter is. We can't have fruitly conversation. Now, this is Apostle Paul. To give you a little background, this is Apostle Paul writing a letter to Timothy. Timothy was what we call today, considered today, like a spiritual son. Apostle Paul was his leader, and you could say he was like the mentor, and Timothy was like a mentee, right? He was training him, and he was like, I think he was in prison during this time, and he was just instructing him, hey, I need you to do this, I need you to do that, I need you to be careful about this, I need you to be careful about this. So what we're talking about right now is Apostle Paul giving Timothy some instructions to make sure that he stay on the right path. So we got to be careful. You know, those unproductive conversations or those gossiping conversations in which we slowly start moving, God out of our responses by start, and then we start adding our selfish desires to the conversation. That's why we got to be careful, because we can get and start talking to someone, and next day you know, we our whole mindset and focus on God, but as the more we talk, and then as the conversation start breaking down, it start leading us away from what God intent or God purpose for us having a conversation with. That's why you got to have the discernment of spirit, or you got to be focused from above, have a thought from above and not beneath, because you want to make sure you're still getting download from the Father and you're not being entrapped by what you're hearing. But prime example, thank you. Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve used to receive communication from God, right? Walking in the cool of the day. But what happened was the snake came and it started talking and it pulled her away from her communication with God, because it was smooth with what it was saying. And then not only that, it was saying words that like sound similar to what God was saying, but it was not what God said. So not understanding God's word, it will allow her to drift into a place to try the fruit from the tree. And then Adam tried the fruit, and then we know the rest of the story. But that's how it happens sometimes. That's why you got to be careful of conversation. It was a conversation that caused the fall of man in the garden. So we got to be mindful of that. That's why you got to understand life and death is in the power of the tongue. We know that scripture. But you got to be understanding real that how true that is. Prime example. I grew up, I was a person that deal with low self-esteem, right? And I would say, because of my, well, how I grew up, I was, you know, wasn't the best. We didn't have the best, stayed in the project. We were poor. Let's just put it like it was, right? We was poor. So I used to play sports and, you know, actually my coaches had to pay for me because we couldn't afford it. But my coaches felt bad and they knew what type of player, kid I was. So they gifted me an opportunity to have a recreational life, right? And it just kept going. And, oh, I lost my thought. Hold on. Let me get back. Let me go back and I catch up. Lord, give it back to me, because that was going to be good, but the enemy trying to take it out. Let's go to Proverbs 21 and 23. And it said, he who guards his mouth and his tongue guards his soul from trouble. Oh, there we go. Back to the football, right? But because I had a low self-esteem, every time someone said negative words to me, instead of letting it bounce off of me, I was grabbed that word. So I started believing whatever they said negative towards me. And because of their words, I started putting myself in a deep, in a dark place. I started going into like a shell, a cave. And then I started rejecting everyone that even that was there for me, because I felt that I was in a deep and dark place. I felt that I would never amount to nothing. I felt that I would never have a girlfriend. I felt that I would never be married. I felt I would never be successful, that I will just be someone that is lost, that I will be homeless, I would be on the streets. See, because all the words they kept throwing at me, and I was receiving them because of the words. That's why we got to be careful. Proverbs 21 and 23. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I know that you have been going somewhere for a minute. He who guards his mouth and his tongue guards his soul from trouble. But I like the Passion Translation of this. Proverbs 21 and 23. The Passion says, watch your words and be careful what you say. You'll be surprised by how few trouble you'll have. That's why sometimes we got to just zip it. We can't say everything that's on our mind. And that's why we got to renew our mind, because sometimes when we get into situations that are challenging, we want to say the first thing that's on our mind, and that's not what God is telling you to say. And we just start speaking off impulse and not speaking with wisdom and clarity. Be quick to listen and slow to speak. That's Proverbs 51. And I think also in James, they talk about this as well, being quick to listen and slow to speak. You never want to respond from an impulsive mindset. I have to get this off my chest. Be careful when you say that, because that means you're going to override any Holy Spirit that you ounce of Holy Spirit you have in your life. When you say, I just got to get it off my chest, that means you ain't listening to God anymore. You just about to say, I'm about to get it off my chest. Let's get it. Let's go. I don't care who it hurt. I don't care who it wound. It's enough. It's enough. It's time. I'm going to say my piece. That's not the right attitude. That's not the right character we need to have as kingdom of God. All right. 1 Timothy, the 6th chapter, 20 and 21. It say, O Timothy, guard what has been entrusted to you, avoid worldly and empty chatter. See, even in the 1 Timothy chapter 6, the same thing. It binds them again. Avoid worldly and empty chatter and opposing arguments of what is falsely called knowledge. So you gotta be careful with people that we believe that comes with knowledge. If it's not connected to Christ, it's not connected to our Father, be careful to be calling that knowledge, because it could be some words that will trick you up, just like in the garden. So be mindful of that. Which some have professed and thus gone astray from the faith, grace be with you. So Apostle Paul was just reminding Timothy, some that have professed, that means some of them that once believed the word of God has now gone astray from the faith. And we see that right now. We see people right now that was one connected and was hard charging for the faith of God. Something happened. Maybe it was a challenge or situation where they just say, I'm a pivot. I'm a turn. I don't even believe what I was talking about before. And that's bad, because they used to be hard charging warriors for the gospel. And now they don't even want no part of it. And now they are one of the biggest opposition of not believing that Jesus is real. You know, then you got some religions, they only talk about God, but they don't even talk about Jesus. They don't even accept Jesus, saying, no, he's just a man. You know, if you really look at it, I think the Islam, I think they believe, and the Quran talks about Jesus, but they talks about it as a man, but not as a deity, not as what we believe. So that's why you got to be careful, and you got to know his word so you won't be tripped up. So you can have that apologetics when you defend. Not means I'm saying I'm sorry. No, when you can defend your faith properly, because you have foundation. This is what God is switching me to make sure I give you foundational words so you can be able to defend your faith properly. Not with a nasty attitude, not with a nasty motive, because if anything that's associated with God has to bring love to it. Amen. Love must be first come forth before anything. And because that's what God is love. So we got to be mindful, even when we're speaking to people, even when people get rowdy, we have to make sure we put our love, the love that's within us, the Christ within us, bring it forth, and they see the love. Amen. This is why studying the word of God is essential to kingdom living. Because if you don't know the word of God or his character, then you can easily be misguided, just as the snake did in Eve, did it in the garden when he did to Eve. Genesis 3. What you are saying can lead to affecting you like grain green. Wow. Now that's a powerful statement. If you know that disease or you've been someone that's had to associate with this, what is grain green? Gangrene Greek word, I couldn't pronounce it, it's long. So it said to gnaw or eating sores, right? Now gangrene in a Westford dictionary is saying is the death of body tissue due to lack of blood flow or a serious bacterial infection. Wow. I don't want to go that way yet, because that's good. No, I'm going to give that revelation. It said the death of the body tissue due to the lack of blood flow. So the Lord went on the cross to die because he shed his blood for us. So if we're not accepted that, then that means we don't have the lack of the blood, believing in the blood of Christ. So we had the opportunity that what we deal with, if it's not connected with Christ, because he's covering us, it's death. We're dealing with death. So it said death to body tissue due to lack of blood flow or a serious bacteria infection. Just think about it. When we are constantly receiving negative, hateful words, it start eating at us. You've been in situations where you're just talking to someone and they just start putting negative words upon negative words, or situations, not even a word. Sometimes it's just situations that get in your life that negatives just start. It's like, man, when is this going to end? You know, think about Job. Job could have been in this situation. It's like, man, when is it going to end? You know, my family is gone. My cattle is gone. My wife telling me to curse God and die. And I'm sitting here with sores on me right now. When is this going to end? But he had the faith. He had enough strength to hold on. This is what we got to do in our situation, in our life, with the challenges we are facing. We got to be able to hold on when nobody else even believe in us. That's what Job did. He had friends to come up to him and told him, oh, you did something wrong. You did, because this God will only punish you. Like, oh, this only happened to you because it wasn't God that was punishing. He was just lying to the enemy to afflict him. This only happened to people that are in sin. See, this is why we got to be mindful and careful when we are going through challenges in life. Sometimes it's not even about that we're being in a sinful nature. It's just something that we need to go through because it's a process. Because remember when I went back, what we had to do? Prepare. Prepare. So this is part of the preparation process that you have to go through to in order to be used for the master. My God. Woo, I'm excited. I'm sorry. I'm back. Do not allow negative words to eat at you like gangrene, because it will eventually affect multiple areas of your body. And I kind of talked to that earlier. You know, it's like eating just think about it. When you get negative words, it's like eating a seed of darkness. And then the more you eat the seed of darkness and the more you water it, what it does, it grows within you. Then it becomes part of you. Then it becomes you. That's what it do. When you get that negativity, that seed, you grab it and you take hold of to it. But this is why we got to understand this, why Psalms 1 and 2 talks about, you know, being planted by, you know, meditating on his word day and night. And then it said, let me read it because I want you to make sure, because I love how he has me looking at this word with special lenses on, because he don't want me to miss anything. Because it says, we're going to read King James, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. And then this is where I want to get it. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of living water. Some scriptures say, this say a water. I think, but nevertheless, we'll go into different translations later. But be like a tree. So you know what a tree does. The more water is near and it's applying the nutrient, the bigger it grows. So instead of eating the seed of darkness, eat the seed of the word so you can grow. So you can get the nutrients you need so you can be firm. So you can stand how God needs you to stand in this season, in this hour. Amen. And it says, let's go to Proverbs 18 and 21. Almost done. Praise the Lord. It want to remind you. Did I do that twice? Nope. All right. 18:21. This is the one I could have switched them, but I'm going to go with it. Proverbs 18:21. Very familiar when I said life and death is in the power of the tongue. But I want to read the Passion Translation. It says, your words are so powerful. And I just want to pause right there. This is what we got to understand. This is why we got to make sure we stay connected with the Father, because our words are so powerful. You want to give you an example? You remember, I forgot. I don't know if it was Elijah. I think it was Elijah. Elisha. No, Elisha. I could have given one of you. When the kids, they was picking at him. And he spoke against the kids, and a she bear came out and killed 42 kids. A young person. I think it's young, because if I read some commentary, it may have been young people, not exactly kids. Could have been like teenagers or young adults. All right, but nevertheless, because of his word was so powerful. Oh, let's talk about Elijah. He spoke and said it would not rain until he gave the command to rain. So it didn't rain in that area for 3.5 years. 3.5, that's why when you're connected with the Father and you say exactly what he says, your word will come to pass, because you're speaking exactly what the Father wants you to say. So this is a lesson for all you inspiring, up and coming prophetic voices. You need to make sure you're listening to God when you're speaking. You need to make sure that it's coming from God, and it's not an emotion, it's not your will, and it's not your mind. It's coming from a selfish nature, because if you're not speaking what God is speaking, you can come and be given that empty chatter. You could be given that fruitless word. It sound good and look good, but it doesn't have no weight. It can't produce nothing, because God didn't tell you to say it. And you said it because of emotion, because you wanted to be seen. You wanted to be heard. You wanted to say, oh, I got a word. It's not about that. Say what the Lord's saying. You don't have to have a platform to say what the Lord's saying. You could just be talking to someone, and the Lord could drop his spirit, Holy Spirit on you, and you could start speaking to them. And a lot of times, a lot of people break free from conversations than even in a regular church service. And don't get caught up where you only can prophesy at church and not in a regular life.
Come on, sir.
Don't get caught up that only I could prophesy to church people, because you're gonna get caught up, because you start speaking to the wrong church person that is really locked in with the Father, and then they're going to hurt your feelings and say, no, baby, that ain't the word that the Lord is giving you for me. Someone will tell you that. Someone won't even pull you aside. They will tell you right in your face, baby, that ain't the word that the Lord is giving me. I think you need to go back a little deeper. I think you need to go back to that altar. I need you to go deeper, because that ain't the word. So we got to be mindful of that. So I'm moving on for that. Just be careful. It said your words are so powerful. I just want to give an illustration of how powerful your words are, that they will kill. Your words will kill. I talk about Elisha, about the she-bears killing the 42 people, right? Or it will give you life. My God, it will give you life. You know where that came from? Remember Lazarus, when Jesus said, come forth? His word brought him back to life as he prayed to the Father, because he spoke exactly what the Father said, and it brought him to life. Life. That's why you got to be careful what you're saying. Beware of false perceptions and teaching, because it can bring costly harm to the people you are influencing. Be careful. Make sure if God is giving you a revelation, if he's giving you a revelation, sometimes you might have to go back 2 or 3 times and make sure this is what God's saying, because you don't want to get anybody a word through studying and saying this is what you think, and it's not what God is context is saying, because now you just influenced them, and now you lead them astray, and you're not doing it intentionally. So I'm not saying your motive and your heart is doing that, but because you didn't go and make search and make sure this is what God's saying, and then you go and say it to someone, and it changed. Because you got to understand, when you have influence on people, what you say, a lot of times people don't want to study the word, so that, you know, then they'll take whatever you say. We've plenty of times, I don't have it in front of me, but there was many sayings that we used to say in the old church that it's not even scripture. But it's something that we used to say, on a consistent basis. And we got to get out of that. We'll just see what God is saying in our life. Amen. Remember, some men will not have the faith in Jesus and his resurrection. There's a lot of people that don't believe in Jesus and the resurrection, as I shared earlier. And it will oppose everything that Jesus mentioned. They become an opponent of Jesus. He ain't no man ever died. You know, I don't heard the argument, what's his last name? Why is this Jesus? I can't remember the Hebrew name. I can't pronounce it. I want to, I think it's Yeshua Hamashiach. I think that's
Yeshua Hamashiach.
Yeah, Hamashiach.
Yeshua Hamashiach.
Yeah. That's his name in Hebrew. So if they looking for a last name, they just say, why Americans don't have, you know, they just have Jesus. You know, that's a transliteral, that's a little deep that you really got to dive in. If someone want to do that, be my guest. That, I mean, definitely you want to dive, but you want to make sure you're being led by the Father when you dive. You know, just stay hungry. Stay in that place. We have to know God's word and have a strong, firm foundation. So we cannot be misled by every voice that is speaking and saying that the Lord has sent them. I'm going to end on that. At this time, Dr. Prophet Hope Hall, it's on you.
How you just going, I'm like, and you just like cancel it. And I'm like, okay, it's my turn for real. To God be the glory. What a powerful word tonight, a very powerful prophetic word. And y'all, the reason it's prophetic is because God is speaking to you. He's speaking to us heavy in this hour, because there's so many churches now that are misleading, so many voices that are misleading. And so, you know, sometimes you want to dive deeper when God said, I need you to just learn the basics. I need you to get into the foundation. I need you to just get into the basics. And you can go deeper a little bit later, you know. And most of the people who have gone deeper already got into the foundation. And so that was really good. But let me talk to you about talking. This is huge about your tongue. You always heard people say, people always tell you that once you put it out there, you can't bring it back. Well, that's true. Once the words are out there, you can't just reach up and pull them back in. Now you got to go apologize to the person that you hurt. Now you got to go say, oh, that's not what I meant. God, no, well, you said what God said. So now it's out there. And they believe you. There are people who don't know God, and you start saying you're just going to go deeper hole, and the Lord said you're going to die tonight, and da da da. And now those words are out there. Now God may have said they're going to die tonight, but the part you didn't go back and find out is if they do such and such, they won't die. So then it's how you word things when you're talking to people. You say, you know what? The Lord said you shall live and not die. He needs you to go and do this for him. He needs you to go and go to a deeper that you, but you don't, you gotta, you can't just go out there and just be all willy nilly and just say, cause it sound good, you know, and it ain't right. And so the one thing that is very, very, very close to my heart as a deliverance minister is open doors and portals. When you do certain things, you can open doors and evil doors and evil portals over your life. When you allow your turmoil into your lips and you sort of speak it over yourself, it's like, I'm going through turmoil, I'm going through this, I'm going through that, this is hurting, that's hurting. Well, you're just opening doors. You're, and I don't mean like, well, you know, if you're in therapy and your therapist, like myself, ask you questions and that you're giving them the answer, that's different because now you're under God's umbrella now. You're under godly counsel. When your pastors or your leaders are giving you, asking you questions about what you're dealing with and you're talking about it, then guess what? You're under the covering of the word of the Lord because he says, seek godly counsel. So you're not out there, you're not saying anything for the devil to take hold of because God is already protecting you. But when you yourself alone, it's just every time somebody yang, 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 in your face and you want to yang, yang back, now you've opened portals over yourself. And the demons just having a field day with you. And you say, oh, I love God. Well, you might love him. But your mouth is saying something else. Your actions are saying something else. Your actions speak louder than words. So your actions need to, you don't need to threaten that you're not going to do this, you're not going to do that, you're not going to da da da, or I'm going to do this, or I'm going to do, they keep on talking to me like that. I'm going to snap, I'm going to do, you keep doing that. And when something happens, you're going to be like, oh, I didn't mean to say that. Oh my God. Oh God, that's why we have to be careful. And even as prophets and leaders, we have to be careful. Two more things. And doing that, if you was going back to the prophet thing, I'm sorry, going back to God, does it make you a doubter? It just keeps you away from the attack. God is not saying, child, I just told you to go tell her that she need to go walk around the parking lot 5 times shouting my name. He's not going to do that. You come back to him and you make sure. If you don't hear nothing, he may say, shh. He may say, I just want you to hold that to yourself till I give you something. So if you go back to him, and I'm telling you this as a prophet, I've been a long time and I know about tax. So don't try to be one just because it sounds good. Just because you get one right. One right and no attack. I'm telling you, the process of being in that place is huge. Being a leader alone is a responsibility. So just because God tell you something, you just go back to him and say, Lord, I just want to make sure that this is what you're saying because that don't even sound right. Then you get to a point where you just know his voice. You know when to be quiet, be still, you know when to speak, right? Okay. So God tests you. I thought about when you were saying, and I know I'm trying to y'all get ready for the trip. So I was off for a little bit. So I've caught everything. I was kind of listening. But I thought about how you were talking about going through some things. Listen, y'all. I want y'all to be reminded when you hear the thing, when you hear this saying, this is a test. This is only a test of the emergency broadcast system. This is a test. This is only a test of God's broadcast system. In the event of an actual emergency, you will be given information and instructions. So when God tests you and you don't pass the test, you're not going to get the instructions. And what happens after the test? You hear this loud, annoying sound. Because he's just trying to test you to see how well you're going to increase, how you're going to hear the sound. Are you going to remember the sound? Are you going to remember his voice? This is only when you're going through some things, this is him trying to help you. Job went through a test. It was only a test of God's emergency system. Now his test has become an actual emergency. And what he has to do is know what he knew before everything was gone. And then reminded himself, let me just give God glory even this. Yet though he slayed me, I will yet trust him. And you got to stay in that posture. And the last thing is, how many people pay attention to the airplane attendants with talking about the emergency exits and all that stuff and the buckles and the nobody really. Even the new people don't even really, they might look at her like she's standing up while they're moving. Is she going to fall? Baby, you need to pay attention. Do you know that I pay attention to her or him? Because in the case that happens in an actual emergency, you're not going to know what to do because you're not paying attention. Thank you for the plane. You're not going to be paying attention. They're telling you where the exits are. And when the time comes for the exits, you're going to be like, okay, I don't know what to do. I don't know which one's the exit. I don't know. You don't even know. I bet you nobody knows where their parachutes are. They will get off the plane without a parachute because they don't know where, I mean, their flotation devices are. Don't nobody know where their flotation devices are. If I ask anybody, and tonight, I want y'all to tell me where your flotation devices are. We're going to see how much you've been paying attention. Come on. You got to pay attention. You know, the seatbelt thing is easy. That you're not supposed to tell them. Didn't I just say I was going to? Okay, see, he in trouble, y'all. He in the other room, so I can, you know, when the cameras go off. Anyway, and so I know if we was in the water, you blow into the, there's a light supposed to come up. See, I know this stuff because I'm paying attention. If you don't pay attention, you think, oh, this is routine. They do it all the time. God's word is not just routine. You do it all the time. God's word is something that you do, and you have to pay attention to it or you miss out and you lose the test. And when the time comes from emergency, when he comes back or when things are happening, because you're so busy engulfed in your own little world and you forgot about he is your world, then you're going to struggle. To God be the glory. I know I got a lot off of that and I only got like 4 notes, but I think they're very good notes. I want y'all to really focus on God. Come on, y'all. Focus on him. When things happen, Father, go back to what would Jesus do? A lot of people thought that was like the dumbest whatever. A lot of people did, and it's not. It's like went through a phase, and it should not be a phase. What would Jesus do? So when you're into a place and somebody's aggravating you, just close your eyes. And, oh, y'all. What would Jesus do? And they say, I'm talking to you. You ain't listening to me. Not really. I'm trying to see what my Father's trying to say. Okay. So I want to start with, if you're in the room, those of you in the room and those of you watching the replay and you're also, you can also put something on our YouTube, make a comment of what you got out of it, what it did for you. Those who are watching replay, make a comment and say, you know what this did for me? This reminded me that God is in control. This reminded me to be careful of my mouth. This reminded me is that would God talk like this? Is this how God talks since I say I love him? And I follow him. Is this how he talks? Is this how he will act? Is this how he, would he follow through with extra anger on top of it? Would he just get offended and just snatch somebody? No, he wouldn't. He was offended his whole entire life, his little young life. He was offended all the way to the cross. So those of you watching the replay, make sure you put some notes in there. Let us know what helped you, what's helping you in your life. And if you need some prayer, please put in the comments, I need prayer, and tell us what for so that we can go back to the comments and see in the name of Jesus. So I'm going to call out your name tonight, and you don't have to say anything, of course. And I already see the notes. And if you want to, you're welcome to. We gotta get going, so we're gonna let you please like about 1 minute. Don't start preaching, praise the Lord, but give us your strongest thing that God. Let me do it different tonight. I want you to tell me what was said that God reminded you of in your life based on this. If you can give me one thing, listening, what did God remind you that you can change in your life? So I want to start with Minister Taisha Taylor.
Blessings, blessings. Hello, everyone. First, hello. Giving honor to God, my apostles and prophetess and everyone else. The word was awesome, off the chain. I enjoyed it. I got excited when you mentioned Psalms 119, 105. That was what Dr. Prophetess gave me in our mentor class. And it's called in the PTP Bible, Passion Translation Bible, it's called His Truth Shining Light. And I've been going through some things, but His light is still shining on me. I'm not giving up. I slid off a little bit, but I'm coming back. So that was one of the main key points, because I'm so happy that His light has never left me and is still going to shine on me continuously. He's pushing me to keep moving forward instead of backsliding. And is it hard? Yes, it is, but I'm still going to go forward because I don't want to lose Him by doing something negative. And as far as when you said, keep your mouth zipped, I put, keep your mouth zipped. You keep your mouth zipped up, because the words you're trying to hurt somebody else is going to hurt you. Because you're going to have to go back and apologize to that person for what you said wrong. And it's hurting you because you have to apologize. So be mindful of what you say and how you say it. If anybody have anything negative to say towards you, or you have negative things, thoughts that's coming to you, take a minute or a day or two or a week or month, a year, however you want to do it. But just be mindful of what you say, because like you said, the power is in the tongue, and that tongue will cut you short. So the word was awesome. It was amazing. And I will be going back to the replay.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That's good. Hallelujah. Yep, the tongue is dangerous. It's a dangerous item. It was dangerous for those 42 boys that was making fun of him. And that bear mauled them all because he cursed them. They were cursed. He cursed them. But guess what? Elijah had a tongue too. So Elijah used the tongue and the power in the tongue to shut them down, and they got shut down, right? So to God be the glory. Thank you so much, woman of God. Also, I want you to write on a piece of paper. I had somebody do this before, and they said it really helped them. So I want you to write on a piece of paper 10 times, nothing is too hard for God. And then do another 10 times, I am from God. Okay, Lord. The Lord said, make it 25 for each. I'm listening to God, y'all. So when you write them, you can't help but to pay attention to it. When you write it down, it enters in. So 25 times, right, there's nothing too hard for God. And then 25 times, right, I am from God. And all of you can take it, but this specifically for Minister Taisha, excuse me. Pastor Jay, you're available. Name something that tapped into you, one thing that really took a hold.
Blessings to everyone. Blessings, apostle and prophetess. I give the honor to God tonight. Excuse me. when Apostle was talking about how we our conversation, it really stuck out to me with how you talk with people, and for me, I'm always trying to make sure that my conversation is aligned up with God, but it's just it would amaze me. Like today I was in my office listening to I was doing my work, but the office next to me, one of the providers was there, and she was upset about some things. It's just listening to her conversation of how she was speaking to others. I was like, Lord, like she's being very rude today. Like that is not right. It's not of you. She's not using words that, that what would Jesus do? What would Jesus say? Basically, like this is not anything that you would say, and it just remind me to always be mindful of the things I'd say. And then when he started speaking about the power of the tongue, it just was so much more encouraging to me because I got up this morning after I did my after in the midst of my workout, I was glorifying God because me, I work out to God to my good old gospel workout, and I'll get caught up, and I begin to go into a worship and begin to pray. And I have been having some things going on as far as health wise. I've had a few asthma episodes today. Then also the abscess that was removed on my neck is trying to develop again. So, and I began to pray over myself and command my body to line up. So it's just so much encouraging as like, okay, Jacqueline, you're in the right place. Continue to do that. Continue to speak over your body. Continue to command your body to do what it needs to do, because it says that he gave us that dominion power to to do the to speak a thing, and it has to go forward. So yeah, that it was the night was just really encouraging, and how he prepared us for everything that we are going into. And you have to be you can't just jump out there into a fight and not be prepared for it, because you're gonna lose. So you have to get equipped. You got to be prepared for everything that you are walking into. And that goes with like Apostle said, for the up and coming, those who are prophetic, you got to be careful of the things that come out of your mouth, because who they think that words are very powerful. You can say something and then something happens and you wondering where why it happened, where it came from, because you spoke it out of your mouth. So I am being very mindful in this season of the things that I say, because first of all, I don't want any unnecessary warfare, and I don't want to say anything to hurt anybody else with my words. I want to always speak the words of God. So yeah, this message was very encouraging, very powerful, and it helped us to stay in alignment with God. Excuse me, and that is all that I have for tonight. Thank you.
Amen. God be the glory. And I did hear something in your voice when you were speaking. And so right now we want to command the angels. We command the angels of healing, the angels of power, the angels of strength, the angels of whole health, the angels of fire, the angels of Heaven's Hospital. We call them right now to descend over the woman of God's place of residence right now in the name of Jesus, that you step into her residence. You begin to touch everything in her house. You begin to cleanse, like I hear cleansing. So we call a cleanse to come over her house right now, to clean the air, the atmosphere, the air is unstable, and we call the angels to come and stabilize the air in the name of Jesus. Stabilize through the air conditioning, stabilize through windows, stabilize through doors. Father, we thank you for sending your angels. We call on the angels and command the angels. We call the angels to come and do what God has called them to do, the power that God has given them to take charge of her health. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, God. We thank you, Lord, that we call now the clarification of her water. In the name of Jesus, we call blessings in her food, in her cabinet, food unopened, food open. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Father, let her begin to inhale and exhale your glory. Lord, let your glory take over right now in the name of Jesus as we command asthma to go. Asthma, you must go in the name of Jesus. Abscess, you cannot be formed again. We cancel you by fire. We uproot you. You are not part of the covenant of God to lay there. You are the covenant of the demon to cause sickness. And so we cancel the sickness upon our life now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we cancel all things that are attached to her lung that's not of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Lord, anything that's attached to her back, we call it to come out and come forth in the name of Jesus. Anything that disrupts her breathing, we call in angels to come in and begin to cause her to breathe in the name of Jesus. We thank you that you will blow air into her lungs from the air of heaven to earth, and air of heaven to earth in the name of Jesus. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. And your will is for her to be healed in this hour. We thank you, Lord Jesus, right now, Father. We release every episode into hell right now. We call asthma up, out, come away from her in the name of Jesus. You demon of taking of the breath, you cannot take her breath that God gave to her. Lord, we call on you, Jehovah Ruah, right now, to begin to breathe fresh wind into her now, as you're breathing your fresh wind into her atmosphere, Father, and that you are creating a different kind of oxygen, God, where you're moving the molecules to compensate for whatever is lack in that atmosphere right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you that you remove all dust mites. I hear dust mites. So you may want to go through your apartment and clear out the dust mites. Find out how you can do it in the name of Jesus. So Lord, we cancel all dust mites right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We glorify your holy and righteous name. Send angel to stand by her door, to guard her, put blood over her door so death shall pass her dwelling. In the mighty name of Jesus, we believe this by complete mustard seed faith, and the measure of my faith is 4D, four dimensional faith from Jesus Christ himself. Glory to God in the name of Jesus, the blood. So we plead the blood of Jesus over her health, over her chest, over her lymphatic system. The blood flow through her veins. Glory to God. Angel, put an IV of flowing of blood through her veins right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for it is done. It is so. Hallelujah. We give you glory right now, God, for it's already done. No matter how long her fight has been, we know that the woman with the issue of blood had so many years to fight and they were instantly gone. So I send the hem of his garment over to her home. Woman of God, begin to touch the hem of his garment in the mighty name of Jesus, and you shall be made whole. I thank you, oh God, for who you are, for you are wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. We thank you. We glorify your holy name. Hallelujah and amen. And all believers, wherever you are, just give God a hand clap of praise. Give him a hand clap of praise for who he is. Give him a worship, because he is no other than Dr. God. He's the head surgeon. He's the ultimate, the head everything. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah and amen. Woman of God, Pastor Jay, how do you feel? How do you feel? Mike.
Sorry. I can before I came on, I could feel my chest tightening. So the and that has been released. So I'm not it's not tight. It doesn't even feel tight
Amen.
for you. So I thank
Amen. To God be
God.
glory. Amen. And as you no longer feel that, we still continue to speak stress release, hypertension release, blood pressure release, release all of those things that stresses the body in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah and amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. And so we've had Minister Terrence tell us that one of the things that he learned is to be slow to speak. That is very powerful. That is the scripture. That is the truth. Be slow to speak. When somebody's going for it, you can ignore them by saying, God, what do I do? Keep them out your ear. Let God be in your ear. Praise the Lord. Evangelist, I think she put up being deeper. To go deeper, glory to God, hallelujah. Great lesson tonight from Evangelist Tina. And thank you, Natalie. It's good to see you on here again, woman of God. If you would like to speak, you're welcome to do so. If not, just receive. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. All right. Miss Gracie, or would you like to say something tonight? Are you good?
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I am good. I just that one word that you just told us, just give. Mine is just well, I got two.
Okay.
The Lord is telling me to listen and focus more on Him. That's all I have.
That's the two. Love you, woman of God.
I love you too.
She said, I put and in between. That's two. That's two things.
Love you guys too. I'm glad my daughter brought me into y'all life. I really appreciate you guys.
Oh, wow. Thank you. That means a lot. I just felt a chill come over me when you said it.
I mean it from my heart.
Amen. Well, we're glad you're in our crew.
Thank
We know
you.
you got you. We know you got your standard churches, but you're always welcome here.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Amen. You're welcome. Love you.
Love you.
All right. And I know Miss Edna, it could be a man with a wife's phone too. I know that you just joined a few minutes ago. I don't know if you got anything from out of here. Or you need prayer for something, you're welcome to speak. If not, I will move on. No pressure. I always want people to learn from others, even if they just walked in. Praise the Lord. All right, well, Elizabeth, Minister Elizabeth, do you have anything to say, woman of God?
Greetings to the Heavenly Father. Greetings to Dr. Apostle Dax, and greetings to Dr. Lady Prophetess Hope. The words I got was to continue to study, to be quiet, and be careful what comes out of my mouth because it does hurt people. So that is definitely true. I believe my sis said it, Pastor Jay, about how we got to be careful what we say out of our mouth because. When you release it, you definitely can't take it back. So it's already in the atmosphere. And once it hit the atmosphere, it could be a whole totally different ball game. So it's best that we be quiet and just watch what we say. When it comes to our people in general, and stuff like that. And so as leaders, we just need to just watch what we do, you know, because everybody's looking at us and everybody's watching our walk. So we definitely have to be careful. How we talk and how we walk and how we act accordingly, before men and women. That's what I had to share. Thank you for allowing me to share.
Amen. To God be the glory. The thing you got to remember is that none of us are perfect. And we have done things that or people have said things to us that hurt our entire being. So why would we come back and hurt somebody else when we know we didn't like how it felt when it came out their mouth? And so we should be speaking things that edifies the body. We should be speaking things that edify the church, which is us. That's how we grow. And so there'll be some people, their minds are no longer, they reprobated minds, they are atheists, they're agnostic, or they're confused because they got so much going on in their head and they call on God, but they're not allowing God to have his way. So what happens is their mouth produces this nasty filth. It's like when you don't brush your teeth for a long, long time, it becomes filthy. And then when you speak to somebody, they back up because now that's just nasty because you're not taking in who God is. You're not cleaning your teeth. You're not cleaning your brain. You're not studying the word and taking it in. You're just reading it. And it's like hitting you in the head and falling back on the paper. You need to read the word to where, like, this gonna sound funny, like the giant where the pebble landed in the middle, it need to hit you and land on you and stay right there. And take you all the way in. Come on, to God be the glory. Miss Edna, I see you off the mute. Are you off mute on purpose?
No, I just wanted to ask a prayer, please.
Okay. Anything specific, or you just want me to just pray?
Just pray. There's a lot of stuff going on.
Okay. All right, Miss Edna. I hear storms.
Mm-hmm.
I hear a lot of storms going on, like as if it's like one thing after another.
Yes, ma'am.
And it seemed like they're weighing you heavily down. Are you dealing with a lot of headaches?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you dealing with some back pains?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Lord, I thank you for Edna right now, Father. Lord, I thank you because you were in control of the wind and the waves, God, when they were tumultuous for the disciples on the boat. And you said, peace, be still. And tonight we call a peace to be still upon Sister Edna. Lord, let her fall upon her knees. Let her be upon her face like never before. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that you sent angels. We call angels of strength to hold her up. We call angels of healing to release every headache, every attack on her heart. Hypertension. God, we come against hypertension now. Offer her in the name of Jesus. Woman of God, and I see you grabbing your chest.
Mm-hmm.
Have you done that?
Yes, ma'am.
Feeling the sharp pains?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we cancel overwhelm, God. We cancel overwhelming off of her. We come against the overwhelmed devil off of her in Jesus' name. Every demon that has, every door, thank you, Lord. Every door that has been open over her life, we're going to close those doors on tonight, Lord. Lord, we thank you. We glorify your name, Lord, that now you replace her hands on her chest to your hands. We send Holy Spirit fire to burn in her heart right now, to burn out everything that's not like you in the name of Jesus. We command it to go. Everything that's been sent to destroy her and her family, we release it off of her now in the name of Jesus. We call deliverance right now. Angel of deliverance, go and sit with her right now in the name of Jesus. Begin to touch her stomach. Holy Spirit, burn everything, God, every dark place, God, any depression, suppression, and oppression, offer her right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you because there's no distance in the spirit, Lord. Lord, we release any threat of a heart attack, any threat of strokes, cancer clots. Clots, you must go. You do not belong to her. In the name of Jesus, we send the blood of Jesus into her veins right now. Oh, arabasu harabasi andriya basukaya, rekandorena masakandi di 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 storabosaya. Oh, arabasu nena masandi di sakatora rabasai. And God is telling you, I am the God of the impossible, which means I make everything possible. But you have to trust in me, daughter. You have to put your faith completely in me. In the name of Jesus, oh yes, Lord. He said, during your tragic moment. You've had some tragedy recently.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So in your tragic moment, God said, I want to be there for you, but you got to let me. He says, I don't be anywhere that I'm not needed. I'm here. Mm-hmm. I'll never leave you. I will never forsake you. I'm here, but you have got to turn back to me. Don't look at your wind. Don't look at the storms. He said, look at me. Watch me. Just look at me. Stare into my eyes. Know that I'm here. Oh, God. God says he wants to settle your differences. I don't know who you're having differences with, but he wants to settle them. But you got to allow him to, and you got to stay out of it. I hear the Lord saying, take a sabbatical. You need to take a sabbatical for some people, because there's some people in your life that is destructive to you, and they're blocking your way to him. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Oh, God, we thank you for what you're doing in her life, Father. The one thing that he said that you got to have more than anything in order to get this commitment with him is you got to open up your faith. And you've been hurt. Have been church hurt?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So church hurt has also blocked you from, because everybody is fake. And they pretend they love you, but they're talking about you behind your back. And so the Lord is he said, I'm here. If you just watch me, I'm gonna show you exactly who to trust. Who carries my voice, because these day and this hour, there are those that carry my voice, even though you don't know that they're there. I want to wrap my loving arms around you if you will allow me to.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus. He said, once you let these things go, your pain will be released. You need some type of deliverance as well. Because you've been carrying something way too long. I don't know what happened a long time ago when you was a little younger. It's like something happened when you were younger. I'm looking at ages 12 to 13 or something. Okay. And you've been carrying it way too long. And he wants you need to let that go. And it's hard to let go when you don't have people you can trust.
Yes.
So you have to release that in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. I call a release on her today, Father. Lord, she's in a hurricane. It's not just a tropical storm. It's a hurricane in her life, Father. And so, Father, I call your hand into her, to her hand. Pull her out of there, Father, because I know you can. I thank you, Lord, for her life. One of the things the Lord is saying, I hear the word forgiveness, is some people that you're going to have to forgive.
Mm-hmm.
Some situations you have not forgiven. And when you don't forgive, it blocks your growth in Christ. And Lord knows I want you to grow. Lord knows I want you to grow. So, Father, comfort her on tonight to give her rest, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, release right now while she's even on here, Father. Release her. Lord, let her release forgiveness, God. In the name of Jesus, I feel such sadness. God, give her peace tonight. She hadn't had peace in a long time. Yet she still wants to trust you. It's just been very difficult. He said he knows that. Yeah. In the mighty name of Jesus. You're going to have to push through, woman of God. So I'm going to give our church phone line. And so you can write the line down. I'm also going to give you the website, which everybody who's watching the replay and here will get it as well. 727-277-4268.
I got it.
Okay. And it's hopehallministries.com. And we can possibly set up for a deliverance session.
Okay.
And go from there. We'll be able to talk more. Just leave a message there. If I don't get to you, we're planning to go to Baton Rouge, Louisiana this week. So if I don't get to you right away, know that I love you and I'm going to get to you. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
You're welcome. If you can, go to our YouTube page, Prayer Life Ministries. Prayer Life Ministries YouTube.
Uh-huh.
And subscribe there and go and watch some of the studies, the Bible studies. And get fed, okay?
Okay, I will. I appreciate it.
Oh, you're welcome, my love. I absolutely love you.
I love y'all, too.
Okay, he put it up there, Prayer Life Ministries International. That's our YouTube page.
Okay.
Prayer Life Ministries International. I don't know why I forgot about the international. I'm thinking about my Cash App, but then because it doesn't have international on the end of it. So God bless you. How do you feel, woman of God, since I prayed over you? And
I feel a whole lot better. I really do feel a whole lot better.
Praise the Lord. Well, we're going to help you feel more than a whole lot better, okay?
Okay.
You're going to have a praise on the inside that you just can't keep to yourself, woman of God. You are in the right land because we believe in Jesus and we don't believe in hurting people. As you heard in the Bible study tonight, the tongue is something else. And I don't believe in hurting people because people hurt already enough. You don't need no, they don't need any extra. Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
Well, we hope that you're welcome. Please join us every Wednesday. Keep it. Join us every Wednesday. You're welcome. Okay. Praise the Lord. We're not forcing you to, I mean, if you want to join Prayer Life Ministries at some point, you can, but that's not our goal is for you to join Jesus.
No, yes.
That's our number one goal is to join Jesus. But to be connected to a ministry that has a heart of God is a good thing.
It
keeps you grounded, okay?
Okay.
Praise the Lord. Well, thank you, woman of God, for coming forth.
Thank you all. And thanks for the prayer.
You're welcome, my love. You can hang on and we're almost done. I saw Natalie J needed prayer. I think. Well, I hope that wasn't a private message because I just told all your business.
It's open.
It was open? Okay. Okay, Miss Natalie, is there any specific thing or just pray? Just pray. Okay. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for Natalie right now. I feel like Natalie, I feel like you're being strong-armed. I don't know why. I think that may be the enemy that's strong-arming you, trying to keep you from your faith. Natalie, as I'm praying, I want you to repeat after me, and everybody can repeat this, including you, Miss Edna. Yahweh. Okay. Everybody repeat again. Yahweh. So you're saying Yahweh in your breath. And I want you to repeat it one more time for me. Yahweh. And you can feel the release of God upon your life. Natalie, God is calling you to a greater place in Him like never before. Things that you never thought that you would do for God, you're going to do. You think you're not in a ministry, and I see you doing a book or a book club. Glory to God, ministering to other, look like other women or young women. Glory to God. Father, just touch her right now, Lord. Whatever battle it is that she's being strong-armed, God. Lord, that this test now, God, we call it to be conclusive to a test of strength. Lord, encourage her, God. Strengthen her, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. I feel like at a moment, Natalie, you feel in the weak place. Sometimes it's like I see in the realm of the spirit in the desert. And in the desert, it's like you have everything. Your head is covered. You got your water. You got everything you need. But still there is like a sandstorm coming and there's nowhere to hide. And I see in the realm of the spirit, woman of God, that there's a hand that is blocking the sandstorm. Now, there are a few pieces that are also coming around the hand where it's sort of strong on you, like it kind of gets into your eyes. And we know that sand is not the most comfortable thing to breathe in, to you don't want it in your eyes. And God says, I'll cover your eyes if you just trust me. Lord, I thank you right now for Miss Natalie, God. Strengthen her, Lord Jesus. Strengthen her and her family, God. Lord, let her not listen to those who are causing her pain, but listen to you, God, that only one that heals. I call healing into her body right now and healing into her mind and healing, God, that she will become a kingdom mindset. I call the angels now of the kingdom to come down and saturate themselves around her with oil. Lord, pour oil upon Natalie right now in the name of Jesus. I call a healing to her soul, Father. Lord, that she'll release her flesh in the name of Edible Sakaya. That she'll release her flesh and stop allowing these needles and these sandstorms to get a hold of her in the name of Jesus. Oh, I thank you. Where God is actually taking care of you in the sand, but this one hand, but there's still sand getting through. Glory to God, because you're not giving God everything. The Lord said, just give me everything. Give me all of you. It makes me think of that song. Give me you, give me you. Everything else can wait. Give me you. I hope it's not too late. And the Lord is saying it's not too late if you just give him you. Oh, glory to God. We thank you, Lord, right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for sending peace over there, Lord. Peace angels, God. Comfort angels, Lord. Healing angels, angels of wisdom. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you. And we glorify your holy and righteous name in the name of Jesus. Now, Natalie, if it's a personal thing, you're also welcome to call the church line and you can talk to us. Again, we're traveling, so bear with us, but we'll have our phone with us as well. And because we try to keep it with us. But if we miss your call, we love you. So you're welcome to reach us if it's more of a personal thing. I'm also a Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm also a therapist. So I.e. doctor, we're doctor and doctor. We're both Christian therapists. So I'm in this image. Christian therapy is ready. So if you need a therapist, you can come and talk to me and see if I am a fit for you. And we can go from there. We're on the last parts of the I'm in this image financial place. So if you're interested in I'm in this image mentorship, you also can call and I can tell you a little bit more about it. You're welcome. You're welcome. My honor. So just reach out to me as well. We thank God for all of you tonight. We thank God for the apostle bringing the word of the Lord, the prophetic word of the Lord. This is so prophetic. He's getting ready to share the screen. Let me see what he's sharing. There's the mentorship. Glory to God. You can still register at HopeHallMinistries.com. You just didn't go through the actual interest meeting, but I can still tell you what it's about. Do you need a push? Jesus in the push through business. God spoke and prophetess answered. So the only the qualifications to being a part of it is willingness to submit to God's will to be cleansed, strengthened, and renewed. It's a 9-month program, the funeral, the wedding, and the afterglow. And it is absolutely amazing. It teaches you as you go. I teach you through the Holy Spirit how, my favorite word, to navigate wisdom strategies to conquering the enemy. And so you have to have the will to want to change. You can't just say, I want to change, and you're still doing the same thing. That's why for me, Holy Spirit is so important, that if you're not meant to be, just not meant to be. But that don't mean I'm not going to love you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so we will not be having service this Sunday because we're being Baton Rouge, right? Louisiana. On October the 27th, we normally have services at 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time at 13th Street Southwest, Winter Haven, Florida, 33880. Glory to God. That's what we normally do. Because we are small, even though we've been we've been in God's ground business for about a year, but we've been working this ministry for 3 years. We're building up, and so we won't always, you know, we have church on Sundays, every Sunday, unless otherwise we cannot. Also, we have Bible studies here every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on this Zoom. The meeting ID and the passcode do not change. They are the same. So please screenshot these. If you need him to put it up so you can screenshot, you can. He put it up there for a little while, which is good. And there you have at the bottom, the church line. You have our email, prayerlifemeninternational@gmail.com. And so we give God glory for you. And so if we don't have Bible studies, we'll definitely let you know. Anytime we don't have any service that we usually have, we will let you know. We always, you know, if we do it last minute, that means something happened last minute. Okay. So, and if we do it, a lot of times, like we had the storms come up. So we had to make some arrangements to do what we need to do, to God be the glory. And so now, the last one on the list is the second annual all white service. I'm gonna say it, Apostle. Wear your white, don't wear it tight. So everybody know the dress code of Jesus for me is I need you to dress like you want to see, like you're royal. Glory to God. So you ain't got to be pulling it down and trying to stretch it out and throw something over it because you know you feel uncomfortable. Glory to God in the name of Jesus. But we're wearing all white, and it's called The Secret Place. It was a secret place last year, but it was Drench Me at midnight. And so now this year we're launching into the deep. Ephesians 3:14-21, the TPT version. Please go and read that, study that, put it in your heart. Glory to God. We are launching into the deep, November 3rd, 2024. So that's just a couple of weeks away. So get your white, your plane ticket, glory to God, your train ticket, however you're going to get there. Caravan with someone. 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, our regular church service. We will be doing our internet. We'll be on live, y'all. We'll be on live. We have a few people that come from, you know, hours away. And so I believe that the all white service is going to be packed. But let me tell you the things. The one thing is you bring your blankets. If you need a pillow to be comfortable, if you want to be on the floor, you bring your pillow, not to sleep, but maybe, you know, we might sleep in the glory. But if I hear you snoring, we're gonna nudge you a little bit. We don't want to wake everybody up in the glory. Glory to God, because your natural man is knocked out. We want to stay in the supernatural, okay? So your pillow is just for comfort. So, and then your blanket, if you have a blanket and you want us to pray over your blanket, please let us know, and we do. We've already had one woman of God said that she wanted us to do so. We are very honored. Praise the Lord. We will pray blessings over it. Also, if you have a towel and that's all you got, we'll bring your towel. We'll have a few blankets that you can lay on. Our altar cloths aren't really, you can't really lay on those. I mean, they're really to cover you anyway, but if that's all we got left, then we'll use those too if you want to lay before the Lord on the floor. And we will have seats available. So if you feel more comfortable sitting up, you can do that as well. If you want to kneel near a chair, you can do that as well. We're just going to lay before the Lord, and we're going to take everything that hurts and everything that is trying to take us out, we're going to lay it all on the altar, and we're going to launch into the deep. So, you know, like when you're out there in the water and you're just it's deepness there, right? You don't know what, there's just deepness. And so that means that there's nobody but God that's there. And so that's what we want to do. And I believe miracles, signs, and wonders is going to hit that place. I have faith. I have that kind of faith that we're going to see the works of God. We're going to see Holy Spirit do some things. To God be the glory. We had such an awesome time last year. There was some healing that came forth last year. I think somebody wasn't feeling well and they got healed during that service as well. Most of our service will be on. Most of our service, well, every service we've had since we've been on the ground has really been taking off. God just does what he does. But I think that when you're launching into the deep, it's a whole nother realm of glory. And so I'm looking forward to seeing you guys there in the name of Jesus. And I think that's all the notes that we have right now. We're supposed to have another specific service, but we're going to wait till we get all that together. We got actually two, one for 2025 coming around in March. And so I'm looking forward to that thing as well. And once we get all the particulars together, we're going to put that out there and let you all, you're all welcome to join us in that moment. So we're looking for God for it to be an overflow. So we're looking for overflow, y'all. Praise the Lord between now and Lord Jesus. I'm so excited. And so we don't know the day nor the hour he shall appear. So be careful of your tongue. Don't allow somebody to put you in the devil's corner. Don't allow for anybody's mouth, their actions, their anything to put you in the devil's corner. Come out fighting with your Ephesians 6 garments on. And your strongest garment is the sword. Because it's the word of the Lord. If you ain't got nothing left to fight with, it's your sword. It's very strength. It cuts both ways. But you want to be covered in all of it. Because you need to cover your mind. You need to have faith. You need to be righteous. You need to be holy. It's about holiness, y'all. It's about holiness in the name of Jesus. Well, I love you all. Thank you so much for being here this time. We're doing really good. Praise the Lord. And until next time, we will see you guys on next Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, right here in the same place. Thank you all for who contributed to the information. I thank God for everyone that was healed tonight. I thank for everyone who got comforted and peace, peace that surpasses all understanding. So everything is clear, Apostle. All right, now I'm going to pray. So seal your minds, but at the throne room, leave them out of the world. This is what's going to help you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We glorify your holy and righteous name, Lord, that they will learn their voice is supposed to be used to worship, not to cut. it's used to worship. Let the voice know that it's been used to speak only the things that you say, God. Let them know, God, that their voices, whatever comes out, you can't pull it back. So when you launch your tongue into the atmosphere, let it be worship. Let it be praise. Let it be thanksgiving. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we thank you for everyone on here, Father, that received prayer. We thank you for everyone on here that received the word, Lord, the prophetic word in their life, God, that they will keep their mind focused and stayed on you and know that they are from God. And they'll continue to say, I am from God in the mighty name of Jesus. And the Lord will do what the Lord will do on their behalf. Thank you, Lord, for every ear that hear, for every eye that see. Lord, that they'll see, God, that you are the most miraculous, wonderful God, you're the most royal majesty, dominion, and power over their life. Lord, let them have peace tonight. Let a peace be still over them. Those who have been traveling through some terrains that have not been the best, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we glorify your holy and righteous name. Please refill the man of God, Lord. Fill him up again. Renew him. Renew his heart, God. Lord, renew everything in him, Lord. Everything that he's poured out tonight, God, pour it back in. Pour it back in, Lord, that he'll get rest from you tonight. Lord, we thank you that no hurt, harm, or danger shall come near our dwelling. And no retaliation shall come near us in Jesus' name. Because we love you, Lord. We welcome retaliation because we got to fight back with the word. We glorify your holy and righteous name in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Well, we love you, Apostle Dexter Hall and myself, Dr. Prophetess Hope Hall. And in the name of Jesus, y'all be blessed. Until next time, unless he comes back before then, stay focused. Keep your mouth on the prize. Amen.